Cast down fear. Mark chapter 4, verses 35 to 41. On the same day, when evening had come, he said to them, "Let us cross over to the other side." And when they had left the multitude, they took him along in the boat as he was, and other little boats were also with him. And a great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that it was already filling. But he was in the stern, asleep on a pillow. And they woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" Then he arose and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. But he said to them, "Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith?" And they feared exceedingly and said to one another, "Who can this be that even the wind and the sea obey him?" We're talking about casting down imaginations this week. You know, in the spiritual battle that we're involved in, Satan interjects our mind with all kinds of imaginations, intending to use those imaginations to cause us to doubt and also to cause us to fear. You see, fear, as some people have said, is false evidence appearing real. I mean, it's not true, but it appears real. And so these imaginations that cause fear come into our mind, and they pretend that they appear that they are real, and they cause us to be gripped with fear. Fear paralyzes us. Fear immobilizes us. When we are fearful, we don't know what to do. We are incapacitated. We just doubt, and you know, our lives can be in a big turmoil if we let fear dominate us. The Bible says fear has torment. Fear torments us. It can be really bad if we let fear dominate our minds. But how is fear caused? There are those imaginations that come in. These imaginations are not real, but they are pictures of a virtual reality, so to speak. They come into our minds. Pictures of some disaster happening, pictures of something bad happening, and all these things come into our mind. And if we believe these pictures, these imaginations, instead of casting them down with the Word of God, fear begins to well up in us, inside of us. And then this fear begins to torment us. Fear begins to trouble us. So what we must learn to do is this, that when these imaginations come into our mind, as we read in 2 Corinthians 10:4, we must cast down imaginations. You do it in two ways. First, you got to think the word. That means immediately bring up the word of God in your mind, which is opposite to what this imagination is trying to generate in you. If this is an imagination of fear, you bring the word of God and say, "No, God has not given me a spirit of fear. I am bold like a lion. I am strong and very courageous. The Lord is my confidence." So you bring up the word. You begin to meditate or think on that word. Second important thing to do is to speak that word. And you say, "I reject this fear because God has said so and so. God has said such and such." You cast down that imagination. Don't let fear come inside you caused by those imaginations. Cast down those imaginations that cause fear. Let's pray. Lord, we ask that you will help us with your word to cast down imaginations that cause fear. Help us, Lord, to bring every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.